Hello, my name is Dennison Rice. I'm a part of OIT, and I work on the Microsoft O365 team. Today, I'm actually going to teach you about the differences between the three different meeting types that you have available in Teams. Those meeting types are your normal Teams meeting, webinar, and live event. So first things first, let's go ahead and start with our normal meeting. So we already all know, for the most part, how Teams meetings work. You can go to your calendar, or you can go to your calendar on either Outlook or Teams and schedule a meeting. I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate that right now. So bear with me just for one moment as I share my screen. Okay, so now you should see here. So I'm actually going to jump out of this. So as you can see, I'm on my Teams client and I am on my calendar. And if I want to schedule a Teams meeting, there's actually one of two ways you can do this. So you can actually find that specific time slot that you want to record, or that you want to start your meeting. You can find any of these time slots here. You can actually click on it. Or if you want to, you can actually go ahead and go up here, click the arrow, and then hit schedule meeting. Either one of these works. It's just whichever is your preference. Now, if you're on here, as you can see, you can choose your time, you can choose your date, and you can also choose what day or if you want this meeting to be reoccurring. So these are your normal steps for your meetings. And inside of those meetings, you can, of course, do the chat functionality, and you can also do your video conferencing and all the wonderful features that you have available in those normal Teams meetings. Now, one of the big differences between a normal Teams meeting and a webinar is that the webinar just adds in one extra functionality and throws in one big, I should really say, extra functionality, which is registration. Now, to do registration, I'll actually show you right here. So you can, of course, go back to your Teams calendar. You can hit this drop arrow down here. And instead of doing schedule meeting, you'll do webinar. So once you hit webinar, as you can see, it has to load up just for a few seconds, and then you get this message here, which this is saying is that it creates the meeting to where now it has registration. So what that means is that when you are creating your meeting and sending out your invitation to all of your normal presenters, you also get a link to send to any other participants so they can go and use that link to go to a landing page or a registration page so that they can register for said event. So actually I'll demonstrate that really quickly here. I'll just do a test meeting, right? Or a test webinar. And I'll just have one of my good old friends, this guy right here, go ahead and part of the meeting. I want to go ahead and send this to him directly. So anybody who you're actually going to add here are all going to automatically have the link to be invited to the webinar. They don't actually need to register because they have the invite. Now, once this has been created, if you notice, there's already one, this registration requirement. So you can also change this registration requirement from, people in your organization or everyone. So that's one thing. And what that really means is that if anyone wants to say someone else gets the link to this registration, currently how it's set up, only people who are part of your organization have the ability to register for your events or even get to the link itself. So Now, we're going to go ahead and review the registration form, which is what you see right here. So this is a simulation of what you will see or what your registries will see when they need to go ahead and register for your event. And as you can see, you can actually put your event details here. So I'm just going to do test meeting here. And of course, you can put all your set, your dates and stuff like that. And you can put in whatever your description is. So I just say test for my description. And you can also add speakers if you want. And then you can also upload a photo if you have a specific one that you want to. Let's see if I have any photos that someone might want to see. Go to my pictures, see if I have anything cool. Yeah, we'll go ahead and give them this cool background here. Look at that. Really pretty. So essentially, it'll kind of show you a little bit of that. And then this side is a little bit of what you want those registrars or registries to actually fill out when they are creating, when they're registering for your event. So if you want them to have their first name, last name, and then their email, that's fine. You can also add an extra field. As you can see, you can add all sorts of different questions, and you can also create your own custom question if you would like. But with all that being said, this is kind of some of the functionalities that you have within your registration page. And then at the very end of it, once it's all nice and saved and created and stuff like that, you can actually copy this link. And so it's essentially going to look something similar to this when they get onto the page on their browser. So that's one of the bigger functionalities that are bigger functionality changes that you get with a webinar. You get that registration feature. There is another feature to be able to use polls in your meetings. But for you to first to do that, it's kind of a workaround currently. But for you first to do that, you have to essentially create the meeting, jump into the meeting, and then you have the ability to create said poll within that meeting, and then you can leave it. So that way, when it is time for you to actually start the event, you already have that poll set up and ready for you, and you're all ready to go. So I'm actually going to close this, and we're going to go over to our next and final live event or next and final meeting option that you have. So we've already gone over normal meetings, right? We've already gone over our webinars. Now we're going to do live events. So live events is probably one of the biggest differences between both your webinar and your normal meeting. This is mainly because it has the least amount of audience participation. So if you do a normal live event, it's very similar to as if you were to attend other live events that you get in some companies or something that you would register for normally. So what that really means is, I kind of explained it a little bit strange, but essentially your audience members are only there mainly to view your presentation. And it is, of course, live, just like a Teams meeting is, but it's a little bit different because there is a small delay. There's about a 20 to 30 second delay when it comes to live events. And your audience only way to interact with you is through a Q&A panel that you can either add or not add. So first we'll go ahead and create a quick little test live event here so you can get a little bit of an idea. We'll just keep these perfectly fine. We'll hit next. And as you can see, you can specify whether you want it to be just for your organization or if you want it to be public to everyone else. And of course, you can do what type of live event that you want to have. You can add how you want your settings set up. And this is where I meant your Q&A. So if you actually have this Q&A box checked, your audience has the opportunity to send in questions. And you can also answer said questions within that Q&A. So essentially, once you have all of this scheduled for your live event, go ahead and wait for it to finish. This is where you'll kind of also start to see some of the big differences. So if you were to look at a normal Teams meeting, as you can see, it's nothing similar to, I'll actually open up one. We'll use this meeting real quick. So as you can see, this is a normal Teams meeting. This is what it looks like. You can see both the meeting invite. You can also see some of the other things that you have in here. Now, if we go back and move over to our live event, there's a little bit, it has, the landing screen is a little bit different here. It's very closed off, and all you really have is just the small chat that you have in your join. You can go from there. So, like I was saying, the biggest difference between a live event and a webinar and a meeting is that it's more of a hands-off approach. So your audience members have less participation power. Really, they only have the participation power of Q&As. They can't actually speak. Your audience member is only attending said live event, and it's when you're really going to present a lot of information to them, and you could have multiple speakers there, and you can actually switch between the different speakers. Instead of a regular meeting where all of your presenters are all up at the same time, pretty much anybody who joins is up if they have their video on, and everyone is able to interact very fluidly and sometimes chaotically, but it allows them to be able to have a little bit more of a voice. A live event is far more formal. And it also can hold a lot more attendees, I'll say that as well. So a live event can hold about 10,000 individuals with a residual overflow, so quite a large number. And then your webinar can hold about 1,000 people in the meeting, and then there is some overflow after that. And then regular Teams meeting can also hold 1,000, and it also has overflow as well. So as you can see, your webinar and your Teams meeting and your normal Teams meeting, I should say, are relatively the same or very similar. The only big difference, like I said before, is that you have access to registration during a normal Teams meeting, or sorry, during a normal webinar than you have with your normal Teams meeting. And then for a live event, your audience is a lot less interactive. They are only there to mainly watch and enjoy the show in some ways. And there is that small 20 to 30 second delay as well. So those are the main differences between all three meeting options. I hope this helped everyone in their hybrid endeavors, deciding which meeting option that you need and which meeting option suits you best for your meeting needs and futures. So I want to thank you all again for attending and listening to this little to my differences between the three meeting types. And I want you all to, if you have a chance, to go ahead and check out some of our other hybrid mini-series that we have, and check out any of the other videos that we have provided. It would really help us out. And at the same time, I think it would be very helpful for you all. Thank you again, and goodbye.